is he doing as an infighter? This man K is an asshole. Boxing to you. To me, boxing is proof that no matter how difficult your circumstances, no matter how deep the sorrow or pain you face, you should never give up because there's always hope. Through boxing, I'm going to prove that there's always hope. It all makes sense now. It's like his eyes weren't glowing blue before, but now they are because of the determination and his growth. It's also like when Jean-Pierre got the glint in his eyes because of his growth. It's like the Hajime no Ippo glint, the fire in their eyes. And I love it. I love this so much. I love the motivation. I love the stories. I love how they're using hard work as like a plot point and how important it is to get better because it's the truth. The true way to get better at this shit is to put as much effort as you can and pour your heart and soul into this shit. And the fact that they're showing somebody like this, I like that they didn't just do a time skip. They showed how my boy Yuto got bodied. They showed how much shit he had to deal with. And now, this fight with you is about to be the greatest shit ever because we just went through his whole backstory and I've been through the ringer with you, Yuto. That's how I feel, son. Your dad died. Your mom died. Your boy got taken off and has to work on a ship. You were left alone. You were a little kid and you got bodied by some dude when you thought you were mad strong. Of course you're gonna level up from that. This is so fire. This story is so lit. Hello to all the boxing fans around the world. It's finally a day you've all been waiting for. It's the day of the junior welterweight top world title match, Yuto Takeda versus you. Hey there. And as always, I have Bob Norris here with me as my co-commentator. Bob fucking Norris, as usual. Has there ever been a boxer like this in the history of boxing? No, the question is, will there ever be another boxer like this? It's the boxer with never before seen talent. Lightweight world champion, you, despite being the challenger, you overpowers the stadium with his aura. He didn't let the invincible champion Jean-Pierre get in a single punch during their title match. Will he just as easily take the junior welterweight title? Yuto Takeda enters the ring as we speak. Today he is called the strongest infighter there is. But Takeda has walked a tough road to earn the name unlike you. He's been knocked down only to get back up over and over again in the division, which is an unusually high number of the strongest boxers. But in the end, he conquered the junior welterweight division. You could say his boxing is a story of hope and triumph. He personifies everything, all my ideals. Hard work, consistent growth, Kaizen, like, he personifies my tattoo! My Kaizen tattoo! Here, move out the way. The Kaizen tattoo, This right here, he is this tattoo. I love it. Can he protect his title from his strongest opponent yet? Mom, it's about to start. It's the epitome of natural talent versus the epitome of hard work. What do you predict will happen, Bob? The key point to focus on in this game is simple. It's how many rounds Takeda can last. Yo, I mean, he's right, unfortunately. But by that, do you mean that you think you will dominate the bout and win? No, it's true that there's a high chance you could win because his boxing is out of this world. But Takeda can last past the second half of the match. He has a chance. Okay, you remember our game plan, right? Yes, coach. Don't be scared. Even if I get knocked down, I'll get back up and fight to the end. I'll prove there's always hope. You know what's crazy about you? Every time you is in a fight, it seems like the person against him is a challenger. Even if he's going up against a champion. Box! There we go. Takeda closes in fiercely from the start. Attaboy. Put the pressure on him for all 12 rounds. The most worrisome is that punch right there. You saw his bouts against Jean-Pierre and Elliot. With your current skills, there is no way you can avoid, much less counter it. So then what do you think you should do? Is keeping my guard up my only option? That's not the type of punch you can block. The guards will be a last resort. The answer is distance. Because he needs some distance to get into position and deliver it. Keep close to him for the entire fight. Don't let him find the timing and don't let him get an inch away from you. That's true! If you don't let him run away from you, all those punches that you're afraid of, you'll stop them short. And a punch seems all scary and shit until it's like, it stops right here instead of stopping right here. You know what I mean? If you stop a punch short, you're taking away a lot of his damage. With your stamina, you can pull it off. Keep closing the gap if you can last until the final round. We might just stand a chance. This freakish talent, he ended almost every match near the beginning of the first round. His longest bout was 11 seconds into the second round. Not once has he experienced a protected bout. a protracted bout. Even if it seems like he's in a different dimension, it's meaningless if his body won't cooperate. Just hold out until he gets tired. Huh, I knew that's what he'd do. Watch closely. That's the guy you're up against next. Yuto Takeda, the strongest in the junior welterweight division. Do you understand the type of boxer he is? First, he's got muscles like a suit of armor that helps him resist blows. I've never seen a physique like his that could be obtained simply from hard work and training. Obviously, his muscles aren't only there to protect him. They also give him explosive reflexes, followed up by a lightning speed shift in weight. He's every outboxer's worst nightmare. And he's relentless it doesn't matter how many times he's knocked down, he'll get right back up. It wouldn't be an exaggeration to call him the strongest infighter there is. But his biggest weapon of all is his unbelievable stamina. What the hell? Is he even human? From start to finish, it was blow after blow in that match. Takeda didn't even stop for a second. Based on that superhuman stamina of his, I know he's gonna be on you like white on rice. But then what are you gonna do? I guess I'll just hit him before he can get close enough. No, that's not the way I do things. What is he doing? As an infighter... This man K is an asshole. This dude K is actually a dickhead. My man said, don't just beat him. Break him. Break his pride. Use his own boxing against him. Show him that you are better than what he's mastered all these years. Bro, K is an asshole, bruh. Jesus, I feel like he would have won either way. Now he just wants to embarrass him. Show him what real talent is. Huh? What's going on? You switched to an infighter stance. Don't overthink it. I have to just have to do what I know best. I just need to keep pushing ahead like I practiced. Oh, shit. Oh, he's throwing close hooks. Hold on. Yeah, there's no doubt about it. He's copying my movements to a T. Bruh. What the fuck? Spent my entire life mastering these movements, but he's doing them faster and with more precision. Impossible. It was crystal clear. Black and white. I've never been more sure of anything in my life. I knew that no matter what I did or how hard I tried, I'd never be able to beat him. Damn, bro, this sucks. Are you all seeing this? I can't even begin to explain it. I'm seeing it, but having a hard time believing it. Yes, plunder all that is which is theirs and trample them beneath your feet. That's what it means to be alive. I don't think that's what it means to be alive, bro. It's like we're looking at a mirror reflection. Junior welterweight champion Yuto Takeda is getting a very one-sided beatdown. What an unbelievable reaction in speed and athletic ability. Yu shows no mercy to Takeda as he shows him what real talent is. And now the announcer saying it, like, how do you get back up from this? What do I do now? Maybe a feint? It's no use. Okay, then my guard. I'll raise my guard. Body. It's no use. The way things are going, I'll just keep taking hits until the bout is over. What should I do? Hang in there, Yuto. If you make it out alive, I'll tell you what to do. Bro, I really want Yuto to win, but I know he's not. That was a brutal first round for Takeda. Yuto! Yuto! Get a grip! Did you see that, coach? I can't believe how strong he is. I don't know what to do. Yes, it's true that he's strong, but listen, no matter how strong he is, he can't be strong on all fronts. There's still something you and only you can do, so listen carefully. So how was the first round? He's strong, but the lightweight division was more... You may think that now, but he's one of those types of guys where the more adversity he faces, the stronger he gets. Just like a hero in a sports comic. If you're careless, he might get in a punch or two. Sure, I guess. What do you think, Bob? Can Takeda make a comeback in the next round after that brutal beatdown? He's a powerful boxer. I know he's not gonna let it be the end of him. Box! I'm sure he has a game plan for the second round. He still has the glow in his eyes. Hope. Exchange blows with him. Just exchange blows like you always do. It's what you do best. Don't get overpowered and lose sight of things. Focus on what you're good at and remember your training. Remember who you are. Oh. Right. This is who I am. All I need to do is what I know best. I see. Whether it be great or small, we all live with hope in our hearts. Takeda throwing punches at the same time he's taking them. What incredible spirit and courage. It's okay. I can hold my ground. I already know I'm going to be taking a lot of hits. No matter how much it hurts, I can keep fighting as long as I stay standing. Do you see that? Bit by bit, Yu is being pushed back. Takeda is going all out and successfully seized up the upper hand. Not bad. It's just like Takeda to go that route. But frankly, K's boxer hasn't been taking Takeda seriously. Yu has barely revealed his true strength. Yeah. Huh? Something's different. He widened the stance. I need to close. Oh, God. I knew it. Once he backed up, I knew he was gonna pull up and fuck this dude up. So this is a little technique you guys can learn. So this is something I learned in boxing. You could do something where you jab, you throw a jab, right? The jab is a full-on jab, but the jab you're throwing is more like a feint, because right after the jab, you step back, right? And after the step back, the person is going to charge you. So what you can do is either you can go in for a straight overhand right to counter whatever's coming at you, because they're going to come in, the enemy's going to instinctively come at you right after that. Or you could hop in yourself right after you step back and do a 1-2, or just put all of your power into a cross. And that would work as a counter, because if the person is kept stepping forward, you just counter their step forward with one of your strongest punches. It works. It works. I was told about it. It was pretty interesting. I always tried doing it, and I never managed to really land it the way I wanted to, but I realized how powerful the step back was. Despair. You've got to be kidding me. I can't get inside. Damn it, this is dangerous. I couldn't close the gap. My guard is the utter loss of hope. Oh, God. He's down! The real adversity is just now beginning, and the crowd goes wild. Oh, shit! It's Yamaguchi! Yuto. In media such as novels, cartoons, and movies, effort is always made to look passionate and dynamic, so it's more interesting to watch. But anyone who's ever put in some real effort will know the everyday mind-numbing pain and loneliness true effort demands. Good. Just 20 more seconds. Effort is a very cold and static thing. Yuto. About boxing. Yes? Never mind. Rest for another minute and come up to the mitts. Okay, coach. Down! Yu's finally shown his true colors. Takeda is down on his knees and doubled over in pain from what seemed to be a huge impact. Can he get up as he always has? Even after taking that heavy blow? I have to breathe. You can do it. You got this. Yuto? He's up. Takeda's gotten up. But waiting in front of him is the ultimate contender. Takeda's in for some real trouble. I'm okay. There's still a chance. Can I find a way past his impasse? Box! First he throws these jabs. Avoiding them entirely is impossible. I have to take the hits head on to get inside. Dodge. It's hard to believe Takeda had been on the ground a few seconds ago. He's closing their gap with such speed. What an amazing recovery. I can't believe he's making this much headway after taking a hit like that. Very good. No. No matter how much I try to close the distance, he keeps getting further away. He's coming. Should I throw my guard back up? Or do I backstep? No, I can't win if I keep running away. The only chance I have to close the gap is now. Oh. Yuto. Incredible. He closes in on Yu with an explosive dash, making Yu lose his timing and aim. He charges like a bull and takes courage to try to get in that close. Although you're the competition, I commend you. Yes, keep struggling till the bitter end. Takeda's not letting Yu get out of his range. We're halfway through the second round. No other boxer has been able to pursue Yu so relentlessly. Takeda's showing off his prowess as the strongest infighter out there. But it's clear that the damage accumulation. How long can he keep up this desperate struggle? I've taken too many hits. My body's starting to slow down. Move! It'll be over for me if I leave myself the slightest bit open. No. I must move faster. Oh no. Down! Takeda's down for the second time. Looks like this one has caused some damage. Yuto. 3, 4. I don't know if Takeda can get back up again. I have to prove that in the end. There's always a will. There's always a way. Takeda's able to get back up on his feet again. He's always miraculously come from behind, getting back up no matter how many times he's been knocked down. But it seems like the contender is just too strong this time around. Can Takeda make another miracle happen? I can't tell if he's lucid or not. I have to keep an eye on him. Box! Yuto, you aren't doing this for yourself, are you? Are you pushing yourself so hard to give hope to people like me? Thanks to you, because you showed me a new world, I was able to overcome the hardest times of my life. I tried really hard, and now even though it's small, I have my own store, and my mom is getting treated for her alcoholism. So, it's okay. You don't have to fight so hard. You can fall down. It's okay to give up. Yuto! Saved by the bell. What a hell of a round. Takeda's made it through the second round. But as to exactly how much longer he'll last, I have no idea. Pull yourself together, Yuto. Am I doing a good job, coach? The other guy is so strong. All I could do was try to get close to him. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. Don't worry. You're doing great. You're going above and beyond what I've asked of you. Keep sticking close to him. You'll get your chance. Miho, Hiroto, sometimes I wonder if I'm doing the right thing, if I'm doing him a disservice. Maybe I should have taught him how to live a comfortable, happy life so he wouldn't have to suffer like this. Round three! Maybe I'm just trying to stop to avoid responsibility. To avoid telling myself that all I'm doing is helping him along the path he's chosen. But! I have to hand it to him. He's got some spirit. But what's really interesting is his potential. He's closing in more and more as the match progresses. He's improving real time. As if he's learning how to box for the first time. Why, he's just like a protagonist out of a comic book. Keep growing for as long as you can stay alive. You need all the experience he can get before he goes up against him. Round four! Oh shit. He's really pushing it. Round five! Round six! Yo! Round six! We're now at the halfway point of this bitter match. Takeda's grit is incredible. He stands his ground and just keeps pressing on no matter how hopeless the situation may seem. Can his unyielding courage create a miracle? So how is it, you? You're six rounds in a real match, and you've got an opponent who just won't stay down. You've never felt this exhausted before in a spar, so what are you gonna do now? Unless you go in for the kill, he just might manage to get one in. Son, please, Yuto. Down! How many times has he been knocked down? Takeda's been stubbornly getting up every time. It looks pretty difficult this time around. You don't have to get back up. Two! I have to get back up. Three! Four! Kid, coach, good being so formal. Just call me Auntie. Enough practice. Come with me up to the roof. Okay. Yuto, it's great that you work so hard, but you work too hard. Well, it's because I'm not talented. I'm saying you try too hard regardless. Okay. Yuto, there are some situations that can never be overcome no matter how hard you try. When you face with a situation like that, when there is nothing you can do no matter how hard you try, what will you do? I'm not sure. I think I'll just keep working hard and trying my best. You'll break. Working too hard could break you, you know? That's what I'm afraid of. Yuto, I sometimes think, what if life is a gift? Of course, life's handed me a lot of lemons. I've lost my most precious friends. But the fact that I was born in this world and got to meet with your father and mother and you, life has been one great gift. So maybe we should just be grateful for the gift of life. So Yuto, you can lay your burden down and be freed. I want you to know that you're the greatest gift life has given me. I see. My life, all the boxes I crossed paths with, and all the people I've met. It's all been... Yo. Even you is surprised, bro. Do you see what I'm seeing? Takeda's on his feet again. Absolutely mind-blowing. Everyone's cheering for Takeda. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. My man's going in. Yo, and Yu's actually, like, dodging for his life. This is beyond my expectations. What's going on? Takeda's movements have changed. Unbelievable. He's forcing you back. Takeda's about to lead the bout. Yuto, he's finally... There's no denying that Yuto's a strong boxer. He's exceeded his limit merely through effort and will. But one thing's always been missing. The freedom geniuses all have in common. The more desperately a person tries, the further they get from that freedom. That's why freedom is exclusive to geniuses. But Yuto got his hands on it. Yuto entered this world without a speck of talent. But he climbed the ranks and became champion. And now he's even acquired talent. He's in the zone. Starting now, his growth will be on a whole nother level. Let's go! Yo, the stairs. A monster has been born. Let's go! Oh, shit.
Show me. What was that light?
Oh, shit.
Let me see it.
Yo! Bring a stretcher. Hurry. Yo. Oh my god, he pummeled that kid. Yes. Yes! I've been waiting for someone like you to appear. I knew it. I knew he was. What a frightening consecutive straights from you. Coach Misaki has thrown in the towel. You. Were you trying to kill my boy? Whoa there, you can't use violence on my boxer. Sure, Takeda looks the worst for wear. But this happens all the time in boxing, right? Don't get too riled up. yo, fuck this dude, son. Boxing? That wasn't boxing! You're monsters. Bro. And fictional Mike Tyson saw this shit and he's like, what the fuck is this dude training, son? To be frank, he's not in good condition. His jaw has been shattered, so even if he somehow recovers, well, let's just say he won't be doing any more boxing. At that moment, if I'd thrown in the towel just a little bit earlier, no, if I'd never taught him how to box in the first place. I'm sorry. You two entrusted him to me, but I'm so incompetent. I'm a disgrace. Yuto? Don't talk! Didn't you hear what the doctor said? Ankh. Yuto? You. Coach. Aw, man. This is just... I should be the one to thank you. Thank you for everything. Every life will come to an end, but I believe a lofty beauty indwells. Get better soon. Let's meet once you recover. Yamaguchi. And a person who always gives it their all in a marathon. That is life, until the day they reach the finish line. Mr. Takeda is very resilient. We're seeing a stable recovery. So he might be discharged earlier than we expected. That's a relief. Oh, and also, we have a young patient at our hospital who's a huge fan. He'd be so happy if he could meet Mr. Takeda. Would it be okay? Cool! I've been hoping we could meet one day so I can give my thanks in person. I see. Mr. Takeda's continued donations have helped us so much, so I really want to thank him in person. My son is a rare undiagnosed disease. Okay, so it's just undiagnosed. Do you know what courage it takes for him to brave that disease every day? We don't know if it'll worsen, and if it can even be treated at all. My son is to fight off fear and despair every single day, and it's not just the donations we're grateful for. My child got an extra dose of courage each time he saw Mr. Takeda get back up. After I get all better, I'm going to grow up and be a strong and cool boxer just like you. Father, I worked really hard so I could become as strong as you. I'm strong, aren't I? You've worked hard, son. I'm really proud of you. Damn, bro. With 31 wins and 5 losses under his belt, junior welterweight world champion Yuto Takeda has crossed the finish line. Why are you crying? Does your jaw hurt a lot? Huh. Is he the kids everyone's talking about these days? Middleweight world champion Fabrizio Santorino. Oh, God. The shrimps in the welterweight and junior middleweight divisions must be pissing their pants right now. Trainer and manager Marco Santorino. And soon after, he'll be coming after us. Prepare yourself. He'll be the biggest fish you've ever gone up against. That spiky head can bring it on because I'm ready for him anytime. Let's give him the best show of his life.